I bow to all the seekers of truth. This is for the first time I've come to New Zealand, because there were some people who came down to India and got their self-realization, who said there are many seekers in this island and that I should visit this place. I find there are many seekers, no doubt, but many are misguided. Some are embedded in the conditioning of different religions, but some are still very much dissatisfied. I want to know what is the truth. Now, if you read any scripture, even Bible if you read, you'll find out that Christ has said that you are to be born again. So people give them certificate, we are born again. You cannot be self-opinionated. You cannot certify yourself that we are born again. It cannot be. If you are born again, then you must have certain powers. Supposing I say I am the Prime Minister, then I have some powers. In the same way, if you are born again, then there has to be complete transformation. And this kind of blind understanding that if you brand yourself as something, you become different, is very outward. Like changing the clothes, like some people think that if they dance, scream and jump, they'll become heavenly. Something, if they take out their clothes, they'll become heavenly. It's absurd. I cannot understand what is happening to the brains of the modern people, that they should have sharp intelligence, pure intelligence, to see that outward change cannot bring in the inward change. We have to have transformation of people. Unless and until we transform human beings, we are not going to survive. This is the condition today. We are living in the age of complete shock, and we are precariously placed, very precariously placed, which we are not aware of, that if we do not take to this self-realization, there's all possibility that we may not be able to exist longer. Now, the self-realization part is very simple to understand if you know that we have evolved from amoeba to this stage as human beings. We do not know why, but we have evolved through some internal force within us that has worked it out that we have human beings. And if we have to become something more, the same internal force is going to do the job. We did not do anything about it. That's why we say it is spontaneous, sahaj. Saha means with, ja means born. It is born with you. The right to be the spirit is born with you, which you must have because you are a human being. And you have to rise higher, higher into the state of a spirit. This is said by everyone, as Christ has said to Nicodemus, that you have to become the spirit. And you have to be born again. So he asks, does that mean I have to enter into the womb of my mother again? He said, no. Whatever is born of the flesh is the flesh. So clearly, I mean, he said it very clearly. You are to be born of the Holy Ghost, and the Holy Ghost is reflected in you as Kundalini. Of course, in these 4 years of his time, when he was with people, how much could he tell? I'll be amazed. I was in London for first 4 years. I was struggling with 7 hippies, and I just didn't know whether I'll be able to give them realization in these 4 years. They were so difficult, very difficult people. They had good brains, but no wisdom at all. Somehow or other it worked out. Now they are very good sahayogis. They are very good sahayogis, and they are the foundations, I should say, in England for sahayoga. Whatever it is, so in 4 years, what could Christ do? Whatever possible, he spoke, he said, he prepared the grounds, but the way Christians have gone are absolutely wrong ways. They are following Paul and not Christ. Now the challenge has come before you, whether you accept Christ as a divine personality or Paul. Because Paul never accepted him as a divine personality. He never wanted him to be a divine personality. Paul was not a Christian by any chance, because he never knew Christ. I don't know how he was in the Bible. When I first saw the Bible, I was quite amazed why this Mr. Paul is there. But it's not me only saying that. Blake has said it. And if you have read Khalil Gibran, he has written a complete chapter against him, saying that I can't understand this strange man Paul. Now the trouble is, now we are at a precipice of understanding that Paul has put everything in a jeopardy. Because he was born again as Augustine, and he has solidified and frozen all that was Christianity. It's not true Christianity that we are following. If it was, we would have been transformed people. But you see the Christian nations, how they have dominated other countries, how they have killed so many people. In this country, how many people were killed by Christians themselves? In my country itself, how many people were killed by people who called themselves Christian, came there and killed them one after another? How can they be Christians? If they call, even Hitler called himself a Christian, you'll be surprised. How can they be Christian? The disciples of Christ, who gave his life, not only that, on his cross he forgave all those who crucified him. That emblem, that symbol of such forgiveness, how could we represent by this kind of Christians that we see around? And today what we find, there are 1,001 churches, they are all fighting among themselves. When I was born in a Christian family, as you know very well. And I was amazed the way Christianity was preached, especially with the Protestants. I was even more amazed because it was so sophisticated. Everything became so sophisticated. Their fanaticism was so sophisticated that I said they will never be able to break this barrier. And it's true in India still, I would say, because the Christians are so stupid in India that they believe that Christ was born in England, even now. There were poor people, uneducated, simple people from villages were collected, and they put some sort of a meat or beef in the water and said, now you are all spoiled, you have all become Christians. So they are so simple, they believe that he was an Englishman, and he was a sahab, you see, we call an Englishman, and that's what is Christ. Even now they believe like that. Such simple people were befooled by conversion and all those things. But you don't find anything good coming out of them, except that we have a number of Christians here, number of Christians there, big, big buildings. What is the use? Where is the Christianity? I do not find Christianity anywhere, as it is about the fake gurus, as you will listen to my conversation with the interviewers who took me for about 1.5 hours today. They will tell you what I have to say about these fake gurus. You must know that it should happen in your evolutionary process, that you have evolved to be a human being and you have to be a superhuman being. Look at Christ. We call him as a superhuman being. He could not be tempted by anything. He could not do anything wrong. He was so powerful. He was so compassionate. He had power to emit such compassion that people got cured with him. Anywhere near him, people are not. They say that there's a Holy Ghost coming from somewhere. They behave as if they are possessed people. They are absolutely possessed. There's no transformation. They do all kinds of wrong things. They commit suicides, run away from life. They are not to be called Christians by any chance. In the same way, I would say there are so many fake gurus in this country. So many of them. They have come here just to make money, nothing else. Some of them have come directly from jail. I think your government should find out their bona fides. They will be surprised that there might be some of them coming from jail wearing some dresses and trying to preach. It is impossible to understand how you people have taken to all these false things so easily. You are also very intelligent. But is it mechanical intelligence that you cannot see the reality? The reality has to work within ourselves. It has to transform ourselves. It has to give us special powers, because we have those powers within us. We have those powers. They are within us. They are being told by everyone. All the scriptures have said. Moreover, somebody starts saying that this is the way you can fly in the air. Now you start flying in the air. Why do you want to fly in the air? It's absurd. They pay £6,000 to fly in the air. This is absurd to place that much. You can just do it without paying so much money by aeroplanes. You can fly. But people are on the, what we call as the Rajasic people. Rajasic people are the people who are right-sided. They are guided by their ego. I like it. If you like it, then it's all right. But the I does not know, cannot discriminate, and falls a trap to all such nonsensical ideas. You must know that whosoever talking to you should traditionally talk about religion. He should integrate all the religions. He should integrate all the incarnations, all the saints who have come on this earth. All the truths of the world should be brought in, like Tao, he should be there. Zen should be there, there should be Christ, there should be Muhammad, and there should be Krishna and Rama. All of them are relations of each other. Christ has said clearly, those who are not against me are with me. Who are those? And what about what Christ has promised to John? John says that you have to get a comforter. What about that? Nobody's looking forward to that. All kinds of mythical organizations we have started in the name of God. And why to blame God for anything then, when you believe in something that is so mythical? It must happen within yourself. The transformation must take within you, not of the flesh, but of the Holy Ghost, is being said. And that's what sometimes surprises me. Throughout, they ask me, how is it you expanded your Christianity? I was shocked. Not only, but my father, who was a very learned man and of Sanskrit and all other scriptures and also of Hebrew. He translated Quran Sharif into Hindi. He knew 14 languages, very learned man. He told me, I don't understand how to make these Christians understand Christ. They'll never understand him. Because if they want to learn through Paul, they will never understand him. And that's what today is the position, as you know, that we are between two ends, whether to go to Paul's depiction or that of Christ. Miracles of God are true. He is miraculous, that's why he's God. He creates miracles. If you want to deny because you are a human being, then you do not know what God can do. God is capable of doing any miracle that it wants to do. It can create any miracle, it can do whatever it likes. It won't, of course, create diamonds for you or bring some ashes from somewhere. But it will create a miracle that will help you, support you, give you faith in the reality of God. But this kind of blind understanding of religion, of reading about it, understanding a science out of it, how will you know that God doesn't know how to read? He never went to any universities. Christ never went into university. The knowledge that is true knowledge is within yourself. Unless and until you get your enlightenment, you cannot understand what knowledge is. Even in the Sanskrit language, we have a book called Vedas. Means Veda. Veda means the one that is known through your central nervous system. On your nerves is the Veda. Then, as Buddha has called it, is Bodha. Bodha means the one that you know again on the central nervous system. But what about the Buddhists? What about the Zen? Zen people also, I was surprised. I went and saw one Zen guru who was now the Archbishop of Zen. He was very sick, so they called me to cure him. And he was not a realized soul. So I said, how are you a Zen guru? You are not a realized soul. And a Zen realized soul is called as Kashyapas. So he said, we had only 26 Kashyapas so far up to the 10th century from the 6th century. And we don't have any more. So I said, then what are you doing here? He said, I'm doing my job. Same thing I've heard myself on my television. A horrible thing said by Archbishop of Canterbury. They asked Archbishop that that was Robin Day, if you know him. He's quite a heavy person. Robin Day asked him, sir, what is Holy Ghost? He says, I'm agnostic. So he asks, then what are you doing here? He says, I'm doing my job. So Robin Day says, I'm also doing my job. That's exactly what happened. Many have seen this. So this is what it is. Not to know is all right, but to believe into something that you do not know. We must expand ourselves to see where is Christ in other scriptures. What is he doing there? When the missionaries came to India, they never knew what Christ was. You see, the image of Christ was somebody who is coming with a pistol. Indians did not understand who was Christ. And Christ is very well described in Devi Mahatmyam as Mahavishnu. He describes so clearly everything that he will be doing, that he is the Adhara, he is the support of the universe. It's all described there. But who will read that? We cannot read. We have blinkers here of Mr. Paul. We cannot read anything. But why read Paul also? Who was he? After all, why is he there? I would like to ask any Christian who thinks Bible is perfect. How was he there? And why did he put his name and his own writings? Because he had never seen Christ. He had nothing to do with Christ. He was not a realized soul. You can see when you read him, you are amazed. He is going round and round the bush and he's just trying to organize everything. So now we come down to reality that before we fail Christ, before we fail Christianity, let us understand that we have to get our self-realization, the self-actualization, as Jung has called it. And we have to see that it happens within ourselves. Now, because it happens, one should not doubt it. It's surprising, people say, then why are you doing mother all these things? Then why don't you do it? It's nice if you can do it, it's a nice thing. Because I'm a very happily married woman. I have got very sweet children and grandchildren. But the thing is, the job is mine. I have to do it. What can I do about it? So why ask such a question? Why not have it? And once you have it, you'll be surprised what you are. You have no idea. You are not aware as to how tremendous you are. This instrument is within you already to be enlightened. It's all there. But because of our ego, you don't want to accept it. You just want to deny your self-realization. Just imagine, because you think that, why should I take it? It is your own right, you better take it. It's your own property that you have. It's within yourself, which you must get. You must get it. And this is what you cannot pay for. That's one thing hits at every root. You cannot pay for God's work. Anybody who takes money from you for God's work, you must know, is not true. It's not a job. It's not a job. It's a sprouting of the seed, a living process of the living God. That if you have to give some money to this Mother Earth, will she understand that you sprout the seeds? She does it. That's her nature. What are you to give to that Mother Earth that she gives you all this? What can we give to her? Can we transform this one flower into fruit? If some tree is dead, we make a platform, we think we have done a great job. It's a dead from the dead. What else have we done? And the dead sits on our head also. We are used to the dead. Like we are used to a chair, we cannot sit on the ground. The chair sits on our head. We have to carry a chair all along with us wherever we go. Otherwise, we cannot sit on the ground. Because the dead is sitting on us. That's what the matter is doing to us. But if you understand that you have to become the spirit, and the spirit is a living process, it has to work out in the same way as a seed sprouts. You cannot explain how the seed sprouts, but we can explain how the kundalini rises. But how I work it out is not possible to tell you. Neither you will be able to tell, though you will give realizations to so many. For example, Dr. Warren Reeves was a very difficult case to begin with, I must say. But he was all right. And when he got his realization, he's worked very hard. He's got thousands of people realized in Australia. Thousands. Not only that, but they're very good surgeries. Because Australia, I think, has a special place. Especially yours, New Zealand, has another very special place in the primordial being. Australia, as I call it, is the Muladhara, this one. And this side is New Zealand, which is auspiciousness. Auspiciousness. You stand for auspiciousness. Imagine what a responsibility you have to be auspicious. Through you, auspiciousness is going to flow in the whole world. That's why I'm here in this country. How am I to tell? How am I to explain why I'm here? You have to rise a little bit to that level to understand why I'm with you. It is the need of the hour. The whole humanity is on the verge of sinking down. But reality people don't want. They want something unreal to stick onto that. They told me there's an Anand Marg still here. The owner of that, the person who started this, is dying in Calcutta. His wife and son came to me, got realization. They are my disciples. And this fellow is still prospering, teaching them violence. They killed 28 people and the police was after him. They put him in the jail. So these people started killing people all around. So they had to release him and he's out, but under arrest. This is the situation. And thousands of Australians and New Zealanders were his disciples. Can you believe it? What charms you is something that is fake. Why? What is the reason? I cannot understand it. Only thing I can say that they look more normal to you, perhaps, because they know how to be fooled. They know how to tell things. But here you have to become. It's a question of becoming. It is not just by saying that you get your realization, it will stop. No, you have to become. And becoming is actualizing on your central nervous system. You are all capable of it. You are all wonderful people. You are all seekers of ages. You are not seeking God today. You have been seeking it for ages and ages and ages. And today the time has come, because the modern times are the times when this has to happen. I hope today in this introductory lecture I've been able to put it forward before you. That is important, that you must think, you must get your realization. It's your own, you cannot pay for it. There's no effort. Effortlessly you get it. But then once it is sprouted out, you have to look after it and you have to nurture it and know how to raise your kundalini, how to keep it there. Because there are problems on your chakra. There are obstructions, maybe with my force, it may just rise up, I know. But then it may come down. So you have to look after this mother, who is your individual mother. Everyone has an individual mother. And this mother is to be looked after, because when she's up, she has obstructions. I have seen some people having a mother who is just wounded. She's in a terrible mess. She doesn't know how to rise. She comes up to a point again, limply she falls down. Doesn't matter. You have to support and you have to look after her. And I'm sure all of you can become, every individual can become a great guru in New Zealand. May God bless you all. It's a short lecture today because I would like to have some questions from you. But the questions should be relevant and sensible. There's no need to be aggressive. If you don't want to have realization, you can go away. I cannot force on you. If you don't want it, nobody can force you. It's your freedom. You have to get your ultimate freedom, for which I must respect your freedom that you have to choose. If you want to have realization, well and good. If you don't want to have realization, you need not have. But you can ask me questions relevant with the subject. I'll be very happy to answer them. The lady who came to interview me, she asked me, what is the response of people? I said, depends on the person, not on me. It is a very good response in Australia. I don't know about New Zealand, I have to see, but I think it's good response to have so many people here who are seekers, who are seeking truth, and who are willing to get to their realization into that state. Then another thing she said was that people are frightened of getting transformation. I said, they are not frightened of any kind of change. For example, these punks are painting their head. Do you know, by doing that, what happens? You get blindness. I have got 3 cases in London. Those who have become blind, their eyes are blurred. These dyes are very dangerous for the eye, and they spoil the optic lobe, I have seen. But they don't mind doing all those things. They are doing all kinds of things, going into drugs, going into alcoholism, going into all kinds of gurus, without finding out what's the result. What other disciples have got, what other people who have gone to them have got. But they just jump onto it. And when they suffer, they come to me. So I have to just tell you that there's nothing to be frightened of. This is your mother. She takes all the burden. Your mother gave you birth, your physical mother, she took all the labor pains. She didn't give you any trouble. In the same way, this mother looks after you. And you better ascend. It takes hardly a second, a split of a second, really. One great saint in India was asked, how much time does it take to get self-realization? He used a word in Sanskrit, takshana, that moment. It's true, but for whom? For simple, very simple people, who are not so complicated. We have bad health, we have been to other people, we have spoilt our chakras, we have done some harm to ourselves, then it takes little time, but not. May God bless you. Have complete confidence in yourself that you are that you are the spirit, and you have to just become that. May God bless you.
Any questions? What was the first part of your question? She's very much aware of self-realization as being possible, but do you have to put your hands on top of the head?
No, no, nothing. I won't touch you. You see, it's a headache to me to touch someone, I tell you. Because sometimes such heat comes out of their heads. No, not at all. I'll not touch you at all. I don't want to touch you. I don't want to touch anybody. It's the other way around. People want to touch me. I don't want to touch you at all. No. The other day, you'll be surprised, a lady came and touched my feet suddenly. In India, they try very hard. And I just said, who was that suffering from cancer? And there was a lady. But she told me that she got cured by touching me. I said, but still, you should have told me. You should have told me, taken my permission. You shouldn't do like that. Could be, you could have been hit by me by walking or something, and she's cured. So it's better that you don't touch me. I'll be very happy, thankful to you. There's no need. Do we touch the sun? Just a minute, huh? There's a lady.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, what help can meditation be in the process? She's been participating in what is called a self-transformation course in meditation.
I don't want to frighten you much, my lady, but we shouldn't do all these things. You see, it's not proper. Because supposing I don't know anything and I try to do something on my own, it's not proper. I spoil it. You see, the telephone, if it is not connected and you are trying to telephone, then the telephone gets spoiled. It's like that. But doesn't matter. We'll work it out. But sometimes I find it becomes rather difficult if you have done anything like that, because you do not know anything about the chakras. Now, please, there's some gentleman asking. What that? What's he say?
I was explaining how the Ajna Chakra, the ego, can constrict the rising of the Kundalini. He was asking, what about the superego? It's the same.
Yes, both. But you see, the ego and superego, some people who are left-sided, their superego actually invades the ego like this. And they are the people who are like people who take, we said, at the extreme and masochist type. They are the ones who take a lot of burden upon themselves and become very unhappy and miserable, all that kind, conditioned people. And the ego sometimes can press it down. Now, because of this kind of movement of ego, also the Kundalini cannot rise. If it is in the center, properly balanced, if you have a balanced temperament, then only Kundalini rises. That's why it is important to have the balance in this portion. This is shown as green, is the balance that all the great prophets told us to have balance. The balance comes by 10 valences we have, which are actually expressed at 10 commandments. And these are, in every scripture, are described at 10. And these 10 must be balanced. If they are balanced, if you have not gone to extremes, then the ego and superego, both of them are balanced. But if any one of them is in imbalance, we have to bring it to the balance and then raise the Kundalini.
Then they both get sucked in as a result of the rising of the Kundalini. Past that point, we become progressively egoless.
It may become a vicious circle there sometimes, because you see, this Ajna is a very constricted, this is the gate, it's a very constricted place, and to pass through that, it has to have a wider area. But it can get by this too much of pressure of ego or superego. Maybe with one rising, it may not be sucking in. But it's all right, I'll tell you how to do it. Good. As soon as I came here, I inquired about them. You'll be surprised. I said, who were the originals, what did they call it and everything. I just wanted to know about all of them, because it's very important. You see, and also I think they were killed, the way they were killed, they are hovering around, they are to be released. You see, they should forgive. They must forgive now. Whatever has happened, they can take their birth and get their realization. Why bother about the past? Forget it. We must forgive everyone. That's important. What's he? You?
He's now talking about, he said, while talking about this, he's quoting Yogananda and other masters on that path of self-realization.
Nothing, I don't think much of Yogananda now, because See, reading his book, of course, you don't know anything about self-realization, what he talks about. But when I went there, I found I was surprised. Some people had their tongues wagging like that. I said, what's the matter with you? Why your tongues are wagging? They said, he told us to do Khechari. I said, Khechari for what? He said, this is Rajyog, Kriya Yoga. Sahaja Yoga is a Kriya, no Kriya. Now, Khechari is a thing that happens to you when Kundalini rises. What happens that when Kundalini comes up to Vishuddhi Chakra, the tongue is a little bit pulled at the back, which you don't feel anything. I mean, it just happens automatically because it's such a split of a second that you don't feel anything. Like when your car starts, it starts moving the wheels and everything spontaneously, automatically, as a result of that happening. But if you start moving your wheel, will you make the car start? It's the other way around. You see, it's all absurd, because to cut somebody's tongues like that, they cannot talk, like dogs they are moving about, is so cruel, I think. It's very cruel. They don't know anything about self-realization. You mean to say people who will get self-realization will be having their tongues like that? What are they going to tell people? What are they going to give others? All these people are really, I don't understand. And I met the grandson of this Baba Lahiri, who came to me. I must tell you about him. He's a very interesting person. He came to me and he said, Mother, I was first, because I was grandson of Baba Lahiri, I learned Kriya Yoga. I did everything that was possible in Kriya Yoga. Then I met, who was the other fellow? The one who talks too much. I think his name out of my mind. He's very old now. Oh, Bala's guru. They are all in Switzerland or in America, nicely settled down. What's that? With all their money. What's it? What's the name? No. This is another one who talks too much. He says there's no real... Krishnamurti. Now this Krishnamurti, he joined this Krishnamurti. He went to Krishnamurti, it's very interesting. And then he said, I started talking like Krishnamurti. So Krishnamurti sent me round to talk like him. And then suddenly realized, what's happening to me? I've not got self-realization, because he's an Indian, he knows what self-realization is. You see? So he came to me. He said, Mother, now can you transform me? It really took one full year for me. My hands were broken, you see, to break his Krishnamurti and break his Yogananda stuff. Thank God he had not a wagging tongue. What will I do with people with wagging tongues, tell me? It's absurd. You see, it is nice to read these books, but there's nothing in it. Now there's another one started, which is very, very, be careful about it. That's called a Shambhala, that I met in Spain. And these people are, the Spanish people themselves are organizing this Shambhala business, taking a lot of money. And they were going to Shambhala. I said, where is this? This is Gobi Desert. I said, for what? For Nirvana. I said, as it is, if you walk 1 mile in that Gobi Desert, you'll be finished. But that's the best way. And I'm sure they must have been finished there, and these people must have pocketed all the money. And they were all, you know, it doesn't matter, we are going for our Nirvana. How can you go to any place and get Nirvana? It is within yourself. Everybody said it's within yourself. It has to happen within. By what? What is talking about?
You want me to speak louder?
Yes, I just...
Can you hear me now?
Now, tell me. I see, because vibrations have to be all right for me to hear. That's why I'm asking you. And what is he saying? Did you follow? No. All right, let us talk after realization. Sit down. Let's see if it works out. Sit down, we'll talk about it later on. You have been to so many people. Did you talk to them? Then it's all right, you better sit down now. Sit down. It's all right, because what I'm saying, we are going to waste our time in all these people. You see, those who have been to universities, to the libraries, to the gurus, this, that, just leave them behind there. You better get yourself here. Everybody else is in the brain. Where is yourself? Even I would say, keep all the scriptures out. Now you be as human beings here. Get your realization. That's the main part. As a mother, I would say, get your realization. Nothing is more important. my children. That's the most important thing you have to have, is your self-realization. All these things are of no avail, of no use. I'm telling you the truth. It's you who is important. It is yourself which is important. Your realization which is important. Nothing else. All this is blah, blah, blah. Believe. Even whatever I have said and talked, forget it. Because then you will feel guilty. I don't want you to feel guilty about it at all. Know that you are the temple of God. Know that there is light within you. I don't want you to feel any way diffident, whatever I have said. Just don't feel. Because you might have been to some of these, you must have gone to some of these. Forget it. You must know that God is the ocean of forgiveness. He is the ocean of forgiveness. So first you have your realization. Then only you can do good to yourself and to your fellow man. I assure you, that's the only thing you should ask for. All right? Let's have it. I have to request one thing more, if you don't mind. We'll have to use the Mother Earth, so we have to put our shoes out and put our feet on the Mother Earth, because we have to get the elements all right. Just humble down yourself and get your realization. Just get your realization, then we'll talk. If you get your realization, well and good, otherwise we'll have to work it out tomorrow. Just get your realization, that is the most important thing. No, it's all right, socks are all right. Just put it. I mean, if they are not absolutely rubber, rubber socks may be difficult, but otherwise all right. Just put your feet on the Mother. Just simple, like this. And you don't have to touch me. You have to just put your hands towards me like this. Now the left side, as you know, is the power of desire, and the right side is the power of action. Normally there is no need to do anything like that. Normally, in the Indian villages I don't do all these things. But in the West, I think we better do it. Because you will raise your own kundalini. I will not. You will raise your own kundalini. That's the point. Now let us put the left hand towards me. Like this. Just left hand throughout. Another thing is, better to have your spectacles out, because it helps the eyesight. Many people have got better eyesight. So you don't have to open your eyes at all. You have to close your eyes. You can take out your spectacles. That will help you. Definitely it will help. Now, not in the pocket, because you'll have to put your hand there. So you can put somewhere else if you can easily. Yes, in the shoe you can put it. Now, be in a very pleasant mood, because you have to enter into the kingdom of God. We have to be in a very pleasant mood, not to be guilty at all. This is a very big fashion in the West, that everybody feels guilty. Indians will never feel guilty, whatever they may do. They are in that state. They never feel guilty. And why are you feeling guilty? I don't understand, for nothing at all. For little things you feel guilty all the time, and that's how you get a catch on this chakra, which is very important, and which gives lots of problems to you. So please do not feel guilty at all. Tell yourself before starting, Mother, I'm not guilty. Positively you tell yourself, I'm not guilty for anything whatsoever. Just tell yourself. That is very important. Now, when you close your eyes, you'll have to put your hands in the different chakras, which I'll tell you, very easy. I hope you can see me. On the heart, first of all, for the spirit, then on the abdomen, on everything on the left-hand side. Abdomen, on the left-hand side, upper part, is the Guru principle. Then lower part is here in the abdomen, in the lower part is the principle by which we work out the divine laws. It's called as Shuddha Vidya, is the pure knowledge. Then again we go back in the same centers, come up here, then we put our hand on your forehead. This is the, as you know, that this is the center of Christ, and I'll tell you what is to be said. And then we put our hand at the back here on the optic lobe, as you can see here, optic lobe here, hold it there. And then this palm is to be put on the fontanel bone area, which is actually a soft bone in your childhood, quite tight, and you have to move it clockwise. It's very simple methods, and one by one I'll tell you, we'll follow it. It's very All right, thank you. Now, please put your left hand towards me like this. Right hand on your heart. You have to close your eyes. Now, please don't open your eyes till I tell you. Because the attention has to go inside. And if your attention is outside through your eyes, the kundalini may not rise. So please keep your eyes shut, that's all. Don't have to do anything else. Now, on the heart, when you put your hand, you have to ask me a question, a very fundamental question. You can call me Mother or you can call me Sri Mataji. Mother, am I the spirit? Please ask the question 3 times. Mother, am I the spirit? Put your right hand, please, on your heart, not left hand. Right hand on your heart, which is on the left hand side. Mother, am I the spirit? Now don't pay attention to others, you have to pay attention to yourself. Ask this fundamental question. Because you are like a computer, and when you get connected, you will get the answers to it. As vibrations on your fingertips, you will feel the cool breeze. This question makes you ask another question. If you are your spirit, you become automatically your own guide, your own guru. So, you put your right hand on your stomach in the upper part on the left hand side. You put your right hand without opening your eyes on the upper part of your stomach on the left hand side. Here you press a little bit. This is the center of the master. All the great masters have created this center within you, and if this is awakened, you become your own master. So the second question that follows is this. Put the left hand parallel to the ground with the palm upward. Now, just now you put it on the stomach. Right hand on the stomach. Now ask the question. Mother, am I my own master? Mother, am I my own guru? Mother, am I my own guide? Ask a question with full confidence in yourself. Now do not think of all the things you call sin and all that. Three times, please. 3 times, ask the question. So the other gentleman is not doing all right there in the corner. That's... Please do it. Please do it. Yes. Mother, am I my own master? Please close your eyes. It will do you a lot of good. Mother, am I my own master? Now, take this right hand down on the lower part of your abdomen, which is the center of Swadhisthana, which is responsible for the true knowledge technique, for the pure knowledge technique called as Shuddha Vidya. Now here, I cannot take away your freedom. In your own freedom, you have to say, Mother, please may I know the pure knowledge, the true knowledge. You have to say that 6 times because this center has got 6 petals. At this time, the Kundalini starts moving. When you say that, Mother, may I have the true knowledge, the pure knowledge, Shuddha Vidya. You won't feel the movement. Some may not. If there's no obstruction, you may not feel it at all. Now raise, say it 6 times. Raise your right hand higher. Again, on the upper part of your stomach. This is again the center of the master. Now as the Kundalini is moving, you assure her by saying, Mother, I am my own master. Please say 10 times as I told you. There are 10 balancing points of the Guru. So you have to say, Mother, I am my own master. Believe in yourself. Have faith. Faith in yourself. You are great because you are seekers. You are a special category of people. Have faith in yourself. Please say it 10 times. Now, take your right hand on your heart. Here the petals are 12, so you have to say 12 times with full assertion and understanding, Mother, I am the Spirit, which you are. Mother, I am the Spirit, which you are. Please say 12 times. Beautiful. Great people here. Beautiful people. Have faith in yourself. Good, wonderful people. Now, raise your right hand in the corner of your neck and the shoulder. Press it a little behind. Please don't open your eyes. Please don't. It should be a continuous process. Now, pressing there, you have to say, Mother, I am not guilty. From front. Take it from front, not... It's easier to take it from front, across, front across. Take it front across. Now, here you have to say, Mother, I am not guilty. Mother, I am not guilty. Take it on the left hand side, please. Take it on the left hand side. From the front side is easier, yes. Take it from the front side, that's it. Mother, I am not guilty. You have to say it 16 times. Please say it again and again. Mother, I am not guilty. Those who think they are guilty are sadly mistaken. As I told you, that God is the ocean of love and compassion. But above all, He is the ocean of forgiveness. Believe me. And what mistakes can you commit that He cannot forgive? So have trust in His powers of forgiveness. And just forgive yourself by saying, Mother, I am not guilty. Right. Swadhishthana. Now, 16 times. But those who still think they are guilty can say it 108 times just to punish themselves. That's why I said you should be pleasantly sitting here, not to feel miserable in any way or to feel guilty, but know that you are the temple of God, that God has created specially. He wants you to enter into His kingdom. Now, raise your right hand on your forehead across and press it on both the sides. At this point, you have to say, "Mother, I forgive everyone." That's a very common complaint of people. They say, "Mother, it's very difficult." Actually, it's a myth. Whether you forgive or you do not forgive, you don't do anything. But the only question arises when you do not forgive, you play into the hands of those who want to harm you. So best is to say, "Mother, I forgive everyone." This is not how many times, but it is from the heart. You just say, as soon as the chakra opens, I'll know. Now, take this hand back on the back side of your head and hold your optic lobe in your hand tight. This is very important also for eyesight. So press it hard. Now here, because you feel guilty all the time, it's better to say once for all, the Divine or the Lord, if I have done anything against your glory, please forgive me. You must say that so that you feel completely rid of your guilt, and if there's any so-called sins, you better say that. Yeah. Now, take your right hand on top of your head, left hand towards me, top of your head on the fontanel bone area, press the palm and move it clockwise 7 times. 7 times. Press it hard. No, put the palm on top of your fontanel bone area. It's rather hot, but doesn't matter. And move it clockwise 7 times. Now please take down your right hand slowly. Slowly and put it on your lap. Now open your eyes very slowly. Please open your eyes. Now watch me without thinking. Lift your left hand about 4 inches above your head and see, right hand towards me. See if there's a cool breeze coming up. Left hand, right hand towards me like this, and left hand on top of your head. See if there's a cool breeze coming in. Is it? It's very subtle. Little above. Move it, there. See if there's a cool breeze coming up. All right, madam? It's there. Now move your right hand and see if there's a cool breeze coming up. Left hand towards me, see. Got it? Feeling it? No? Sure. You? Let's see one. Fighting you should. It's there, now you got it, without touching me. Little higher up, you all should get it. Don't think about it, don't think. Thinking will bring it down. This tea is got it. Now, just see this thing. On other hand, try with the other hand. Put both the feet like that, I think you're sitting. Ah, yes, now it will work. Put your right hand towards me. Right hand. Now? Air condition has been turned out, so you don't have false ideas. And if you see, there is no thought in your mind. You can watch me without thinking. Just test it. Can you do that? Put your both the hands towards me and see, can you do it? There's one more thing, if you try, will help you a lot. You put both your hands towards the sky and push back your head and ask a question, Mother, is this the cool breeze of the Holy Ghost? Mother, is this the Brahma? Is this the Rukh? Is this the all-pervading power of God? Ask the question. Now better. Now bring it down. See. See now, in the hands. Are you feeling it? Feeling? In the head? No? It will work out. Put your hands like this. Just it will work out. It has to work out. I'll tell you now how to raise your own kundalini. It's very simple. You have to put your hand before your kundalini while seated. Just put like this. And you have to move the right hand like this to go up. But first of all, we have to give a protection to our auras which are around. Sometimes these auras can be disturbed. So first you give a protection by using your hand, because the kundalini is flowing through your hand, you may not be feeling it, you will feel it after you have raised the kundalini more. Because it's a very small wee bit, just like a hair, it rises in the beginning and opens you out. But you will feel it. If you feel like this, you can feel it in the hand. It's sort of a sensation. Right? Now, do one thing. That you first of all put your left hand towards me, and give yourself a, what we call a bandhan, meaning the protection of the power that is flowing through the right hand. How you do it? You take your left hand, right hand, like this, and put it on the sides. One. Again. Is two. Again. Is the three. Then again. Don't think. The four. Then again, the five. You're feeling guilty. Six. Again, the seven. After doing this, you can raise your kundalini very easily. Now, put the left hand like this before your kundalini. This right hand, you should move in this direction. Up, forward, downward, backward, like that. Let us move it and raise the, pay attention to the left hand and raise the left hand and let it move. Let's do it. Take it above, on top of your head, turn your head like that and twist it a little bit and give it a knot, one knot. Now, some people are doing wrongly, little bit. Again, try to see that you do it this way. Twice. Yes, let us have it. Now, push back your head, push back your shoulders. Now, it is two. Third time, three. That's all. You will raise your kundalini yourself. See, the hand is moving much faster now. Now raise it higher. One, is two, is three. Now see in the hands, you feel better. See now? Like this. Better? I can see the smiles. Are you feeling? Very cool, please, yeah. Who's feeling there? You're feeling there? Those who are feeling the cool breeze in the head or in the hands, please raise your both the hands. I would like to see how many are there. So many? Now, those who are not feeling should not feel there's anything wrong. We'll work it out. And it can be worked out. If you have time, just see them. Those people who are not feeling. But those who are feeling it can come and talk to me. But those who are not feeling, these people, there are some Sahaja Yogis, they will see them.